Hi everybody, I am Juan Pablo Sabines and I'm here to present you my analysis of three music festival websites that will serve as an inspiration to a website that I'll do on my own myself this weekend about another music festival. First of all, we start with the most popular festival in the world as of right now, which is Tomorrowland. And it is a style, as you can see, that is very consistent with the brand. The first thing you see, it is a video that works perfectly. And when you click on that button that says practical, it leads you to this. This is what you see, a lot of information about the event, everything on its place, everything is working just fine. It doesn't feel overwhelming and I can find what I'm looking for very quickly. And also you can find this site on French and Dutch as well. I like this part. It's a timetable of artists and dates and stages. It's very easy to use and complete, a nice feature that you rarely see somewhere else. And this is the mobile version, it works just as well. Overall, it has a very consistent aesthetics, a lot of information, and all of the information is in its proper place. Second of all, we got Rock in Roma, a festival that apparently lasts over a month, and it's somewhat simple. This website, you have only two pages mainly. If you click on lineup, you see some of the artists that will play. You click on one of them and more info appears, like their official websites and when and where they're gonna be playing. It is quite useful, I could say. But if you click on tickets, this is what happens. You can only buy them by going to another page. You have to go to another site, like for example the one in the left bottom, which is only in Italian and that is not consistent with the website nor with its aesthetics. I didn't like that at all. And there's another menu that you can click on with more options, but I don't think the colors used here or the settings in general match the rest of the website. This is a mobile version, it works just fine. But overall, I didn't like it a lot, the aesthetics of this website. It has just enough information, it's a bit tough to buy tickets, but I think it does its job, but it doesn't go the extra mile in comparison to the former website. Last but not least, we have Lollapalooza, which at first it seems like the one with the best aesthetics. They are consistent throughout the website and consistent with the brand as well. An example of that is this illustration, which I don't know what it means, but that definitely matches the rest of the website. Here's the tickets page as well with enough information about the festival, the experience page that has a lot of interesting things, just such as this video. It all works just fine and it doesn't slow down the rest of the features. Here's the rest of the information, very complete, and it's still consistent with the brand regarding colors and fonts, very visually appealing, at least for me. Finally, this is the mobile version which changes a few things, but that works just as well. I definitely like this website the best, not only for the aesthetics, but because of how every piece of information is easy to find and matches everything around it. That was it, thank you all for watching.